Hello, Atlas lovers. Mama has a big one for you today. I am here at an undisclosed location in New York City with Geert Wilders. Hero, legend, freedom fighter. He is a member of Parliament of his own party, the Freedom Party.
Yes.
In the Netherlands. And I wanted to discuss with him the current status of the increasing Islamification of Europe. Now, you came to America. What's your objective?
Well, my objective is to speak to the American audience and to warn them that Europe, they are losing Europe if they have not already lost Europe to the terrible process of Islamization of our continent. And my point today will be that America might be the last man standing alone in the fight for the preservation of our culture, in the fight against, once again, the Islamization of our Western societies. And that, indeed, when you talk about what is happening in Europe today, with the influx of Islam, a culture that indeed, like I believe, it's not a culture, but a token, an ideology of retardedness, of backwardness, and wants only one thing, and that is not to assimilate in our societies, but to submit everything that we stand for. And at the end of the day, Europe will lose its freedom, will lose its democracy, will lose everything that we stand for. And unfortunately, you know, the political elite in the Netherlands and in Europe, all throughout Europe, they look in the other direction. They are very politically correct, and they are in favor of the biggest disease that we have today in Europe, which is called multiculturalism and cultural relativism, that all cultures are equal, which they are not. And we see it in the streets of our cities in Europe every day, that the violence, that everything that is happening to our societies is going for the worst. And let me tell you that today we have in Europe like 54 million Muslims. And my point is not so much against the Muslims, but against the ideology. And I believe that even though there might be moderate Muslims, that the moderate Islam is non-existent. And that we should not treat Islam as just another leaf on the tree. That there is one leaf that is called Christianity, one leaf that is called Judaism, that Islam indeed is something that wants to kill the tree, that everything that we stand for, and that Islam indeed is an ideology that can only be compared to ideologies like communism, like fascism, like national socialism, and that if we don't wake up very soon, that not only Europe will be lost, but America will indeed stand alone in the fight against the preservation of our common heritage, that is everything about Islam.
This was what Mark Steinitz thought in his book, America Alone. But America has problems of her own. I'd like your opinion, looking over the pond, so to speak, towards our increasing Islamification of America. I'm sure you see what's happening with the Muslim kunbats in the airports and in the schools.
Yes.
Also the Saudis buying the textbook companies, and so the children have three chapters, two on Islam, one on the Prophet Muhammad. It's all very small, all very insidious. At the same time, the State Department is bringing in, they're importing whole Muslim communities from Somalia. And now what's happening is right now there have been violent protests in Greeley because they want their print on. Now the other workers said, no, why should we have to suffer? That's not fair. So it's come to contretemps, and there's been violent fighting. Now this, I think, is just the beginning. Because, again, this is a technique to get people to back down.
But exactly. I fully subscribe to what you just said. And everything that you just mentioned also happened in Europe some years ago. And indeed, I remember when I arrived at Washington Airport yesterday, that was just before the customs, there was a big sign which says, welcome to the United States. I don't know if you've ever seen it. And there were three headscarves, Muslim women on it, and a big mosque in the background. I mean, this is the first thing I saw when I arrived at Washington Airport. And I thought, well, what is happening here? And of course, when you see what you just described, I think that also here in the United States, people should get some kind of awareness, some kind of sense of urgency that the society is changing, that the multiculturalism and the political correctness, and to give in every time an inch, but at the end of the day it will be many yards or many meters, as we say in Europe, you will lose your country as well. So what I hope, not only for European politicians, but also for the American politicians, and especially for the American public, that be aware more that we are not dealing with just some other religion. We are dealing in the United States, in the more we give in, the more we compromise, the more we appease to them, it is not seen as a token of strength, it is seen as a token of weakness.
And
it's surrender, it's weakness, and they will never stop, never, until they submit all of us. It sounds now to some people a little bit extreme, a little bit over the top, but believe me, it is not. If you look at the cities, the major cities in the Netherlands, half of the people under the age of 18 in the Netherlands, and cities like Amsterdam, like Rotterdam, are already from Muslim origin. And this is today not happening in the United States. But it will happen. If it's not today, then it will be tomorrow or the day after. And when it comes to the right of women, when it comes to the right of homosexuals, when it comes to the freedom of speech, when it comes to everything that we cherish, it will all vanish sooner or later. And I wish there were more politicians, also here in the United States. Of course, you have some. We met a congresswoman last night. Day after tomorrow, I will meet Senator Tancredo, who was also some good initiatives. But the majority of the politicians, unfortunately, is looking only on the short term and on the re-election on the short term. Whereas the long run, and this long run is not something about decades, but about years, like I said, it's a process that must be stopped. The sooner the better. And to speak out means that you take a risk, like yourself are in a lot of hassle for the things you said, and you're a very brave woman to do that. But it's the only way. It's the only way to speak out and to say, well, let's stop the immigration, let's stop the Islamization. Be more proud. There's nothing wrong with that. Be more proud on our own identity, on our own culture, on our own freedom of speech. And the more Islam comes to the United States, the more Islam comes to Europe, the more it will kill everything that we stand for. The Quran is not a book, a holy book. The Quran is a fascist book. There is no other word for that. And the so-called Prophet Muhammad was not a nice man that people should follow. He was a murderer. He was a pedophile. If he would be in the United States today, he would probably be executed for the things he did. And those are realities. Those are strong words, but those are the realities. And we should face it. If we don't, once again, we will regret it. Maybe not you and me, but our children, our grandchildren, will wake up one day in a totally different America. And this is something I believe that America and Europe do not deserve.
Well, the problem in America is that the media has been complicit.
Yes.
There is a power without accountability, and they will not discuss Islam. There's an honor killing in America, and the first half of the article describes the honor killing, and she was not a good Muslim, and she embarrassed the family. And then the second half is the reporter saying, this is not Islamic in nature. Other tribes do this. This has nothing to do with Islam. So people are confused because the information that they're getting is dishonest, it's a lie, and everybody is saying the same thing. Now, Senator Tancredo came up with a Jihad Prevention Act.
Yes.
And that's what's called the Jihad Prevention Act. And he wants to bar the entry of foreign nationals who advocate Sharia, and in addition, make legislation that would make the advocacy of Sharia by radical Muslims already in the United States a deportable offense.
But I think it's a very, very great initiative from your Senator Tancredo. I think I would fully subscribe to the letter proposal you mentioned, that if you advocate Sharia, you should be expelled. But I would personally, I proposed in my Dutch parliament when it comes to the first proposal, I think we should be tougher. We should not only not allow, for the time being, Muslims who are in favor of the Sharia, but we should have a full stop of immigration from Muslim countries until we resolve our problem, until we really stop thinking like cultural relativists, until we really identify who we are and start being proud of that. And before we have done that, we still have a lot of things to do, not only like...
Okay, we're going to keep... I don't know what I lost.
Pamela, do you remember Dr. Eldad, of course?
Eldad, hi.
You're welcome.
Okay. We're recording now.
I'm recording now with the stuff we don't need. Okay. I don't know where I lost you, which is a pity because I'm going to start crying. I'm going to start crying. Okay.
And it's a lot of noise.
Well, that may be a problem. This may not have been suitable because it's maybe too loud.
Maybe we can do it after the in the hotel. In the restaurant.
I'm just saying, I want to get everything you can
say.
Okay, let's keep going. Maybe it won't, but this is your one. Even with Bache, we found a closet.
Okay, we will find
it. Giselle, and David kept opening the closet. Are you done? You're finished.
He's a nice man.
I love him. I mean, he takes it on in the UN, and I don't know how. You're dying to throw him out.
I know.
You're dying to throw him out.
We try every month again to push him.
I know. But what's interesting with the UN and the Organization of Islamic Countries is that they've instituted their own, the Cairo Declaration of which supersedes everything prior to that.
Yes. Well, in the Cairo Declaration, I think it's two articles, Article 2, and the last article of this declaration says that human beings have human rights, but they are all bound to the boundaries of Sharia.
Yes.
So what I found, this is what the point I made many times to our own Minister of Foreign Affairs in the Netherlands, how can we have any kind of serious relations with countries in the United Nations, but also bio multilateral, that really are in favor and subscribe to this Cairo Declaration to the Sharia. I mean, and this is what you see happening today in Europe. We had a minister, an attorney general in the Netherlands, who said, well, if Holland would ever have a Muslim majority, I would subscribe to the fact that the Sharia would be implemented. We saw in the United Kingdom last week that they already are implementing, in fact, the Sharia. I mean, we are already losing very rapidly our culture and our societies to a culture of backwardness, to retardedness,
to barbaric.
Yes, like what Mr. Sultan said very wisely. It's not controversial or clash of civilization. It's between one civilization and backwardness, retardedness, and this is what people should see. I think this is why I made my movie Fitna as well, not with actors like my friend Ishi Ali made in the past a very impressive movie called Obsession.
Submission.
A very good movie. But what I try to do is use verses, surahs from the Quran, and use real images. No actors, but real images. Let people see what Islam stands for today. And if you would even make an effort to make such a movie about Judaism, about Christianity, you would fail. And this shows that today, this terrible fascist book, the Quran, is still, unfortunately, inspiring millions of people out of the billions of Muslims in the world, increasingly amount of radical Muslims, to act against us. And once again, not to integrate in our societies, but to submit us, to rule over us. And this is also why my friend, Professor Al-Dad, I support him so much in this initiative when it comes to meeting in Israel for lawmakers to come together, because the fight against Israel is a fight against the West. They are taking the blows that are not only meant for Israel, but are meant for us. And like you rightfully said, this is not a territorial conflict. If, God forbid it, if one day Israel would be gone off the earth, the Muslims would have their say, it would not be the end of the conflict, it would be the beginning of the conflict, and Europe would be
the first major victory.
Yes. I wish we had of course, I'm not a war kind of guy. I'm a normal, I hope, responsible politician. But sometimes I hoped we had a conventional war against Muslim countries. But unfortunately, we have something far worse. We have, after you saw in Europe, twice in the last 1500 years, that Muslims tried to invade our country. Once they were to stop them in Poitiers, once they were to stop them in Vienna. Now, Charles Martel. Now exactly the same is happening, only without violence. And we are letting them, we are inviting them by immigration, by giving them everything that they stand for, by appeasing to every wish they have And it's the worst kind of war. Actually, this is a war, only we are helping them. We are all the chamberlains of the 21st century.
Well, there's thousands of them. There's thousands of chamberlains. You're in Europe, you're in the UK now, and they are actually giving welfare benefits to men with multiple wives. The more wives that you have, the more money you get. And when they have to go into a house where there is explosives, or there's some terror activity, and they have to bring dogs in, the bomb sniffing dogs, the dogs have to wear little booties because they're unclean.
Can you imagine that happening today? I mean, if I read it, and you're fully right, this is all what is happening in my country. Even worse things are happening. I think we are traitors to our own country, to our own identity.
We should
act, not talk, not appease, but act. And like I said, there's only one solution. This is stop the Islamization, stop the building of new mosques, close Islamic schools where young girls and boys are growing up. And our head is being filled with an ideology of hatred and submission. And stop it, stop the influx, stop the immigration, not only of people who believe in the Sharia. You know the concept of taqiyya.
Yes.
If a Muslim in the Netherlands or anywhere else in Europe says, because he knows that he can stay that way, the right things. Believe me, if the Muslim ideology will become more prominent, doesn't even have to be dominant, it doesn't have to be 51%, but if it becomes more prominent, and you see it in countries where the Muslim population is 10, 15, 20, 25%, taqiyya means that they will change their tune. And at the end of the day, they will never choose for a society in the West, but they will choose for Islam. And this is happening today. And instead of our governments and our politicians and the press corps, is fighting against it and showing the public in an honest and transparent way what is happening, they are looking in the other direction, and people like you and me who stand up are being labeled as racist and as idiots, but we are not. So the only thing we can do is try to speak out, educate, make movies, make weblogs, do everything possible to show the people the reality.
We'll do it again in the Four Seasons.
Yes.
Because I think it's getting more and more.
Yeah, we will do it again. Okay.